Hello YouTube, Jedimon2005 here with a review of the Kamen Rider Eternal figure for Red Flare. So this is the form of Eternal from the V-Cinema Eternal movie that was really epic beyond all belief. So what we see here is a similar box to what we're used to for double figure. It's Eternal's white. We got a white box. We got red writing. Kamen Rider Eternal, Red Flare, and then the flame. Awesome. Red Flare right there, like, ah, kick your ass. We see this one was a Toei Hero Net exclusive. So Eternal was Bandai Collector Shop. This one was Toei Hero Net. Probably because Shuki said it was going to be. We see the Eternal movie logo, and then coming under Eternal, Red de Flare. We see the name on the side with a bunch of flames, looking epic. And then on the back, him standing here in the Junkazu pose, because, spoilers, he's Red Flare. We see him holding up his hand like, yo, the big accessories, and then the big cape on regular Eternal, right there. So let's pull this all out. Now, the big cape is why this box is so thick. So we have this back tray here with the flaring cape, and then we have this here, which just has Red Flare Eternal and the hands. So let's go ahead and take this out. I should be able to take it open. There we go. Oh crap. I just shook the hands up. I hate when that happens. Hashtag what the fuck. Alright, so damn it. There we go. Get him out. Now, this is about the 15th or so time we've reviewed the double mold. Because that's all this really is the double mold. So let's take a look. It's the Eternal head. Obviously, we see the yellow compound eyes. We see the big sideways E for Eternal. Eternal. White armor, the shoulder pads, the red flare, the plastic. There's plastic on here that I didn't even see until 10 seconds ago. So, how do I get this off? Oh, I guess it just slides off. Derp. One side and the other. So, sideways E, shoulder armor, the flames looking really epic. The red arms, lost driver, maximum drive slot, the legs, all that stuff, the anklets, him from the back. So, that's basically this figure. We're done. Bye. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. That'd be stupid. Articulation-wise, his head's good. His arms are good. Nothing feels loose either. Legs feel really nice. Because we all know double figuarts are known for their loose leg problems. Die-cast feet. So they're doing a lot of that, actually, with these past few figures we've been reviewing. We've seen a lot of die-cast feet, which is good. And he falls over. Derp. So, let's grab regular Eternal off the display next to me. Very carefully. And let's dust off his cape. He's been there a little bit. He's kind of dirty. Alright, so here's a regular Eternal with his dagger and thumbs downing you. But he's like, I'm anti-Kuga. I'm the anti-Godai. Godai thumbs up, I thumbs down. I don't know why he talks that way. So we'll put him here. So let's do this. We can take his head off and pop this cape off.
Oh my god, he's decapitated!
And then we'll take this cape out. So we see his cape right here. And it actually goes this way, so we'll just stick it on. It should, I would think it would go further than that. I guess it doesn't. P. people with my name. That's stupid. Am I supposed to take the whole neck off? Actually, I might have to take his neck off. I think that's what they want me to do. They gotta take the whole neck off for this one. How am I gonna do that without a head? Hold on. Oh, yeah, I can't do it. Like, literally, not like, I can't do it. There we go. So I got his neck off now. There we go. We'll stick this cape back in. Now we're going to stick the neck joint back on to hold the cape on. And then his head. And then it all's on and it all stays. And or it doesn't. There we go. Turn the neck properly. Might help a little. Oh my god, I dropped his head! Okay. This cape is dumb. Just saying. So, good enough, right? So here he is with his flowing cape. We got him to stand with it, which is pretty cool. So there's Eternal with this cape. We'll put him in the back. And let's get Red Flare into a pose. Let's do... Actually, I like the one on the top, on the front of the box. So we'll get those hands out, which hopefully has something close, which we really don't. So we'll pretend with these open hands that they're the same thing. So we're going to go ahead and pop on these open hands onto his wrists. One thing I hate about double figure arts is these damn armlets, bracelet things that keep popping off when you try to put hands on them. Come on, hand, go on properly. There we go. So, I got these hands on. So this hand is going to come up across this way, like I'm badass. This hand's going to come across this way, like can't touch this. No. Except for you. You can touch me. So here we have Red Flare with Eternal. So there we have it. Again, is this figure worth it? Nah. I mean, if you want to get this cool new cape for Eternal, then yeah, go ahead and get him. If you like the Eternal movie and want to have both forms of Eternal, even though it's a different person, then sure, go ahead and get it. Otherwise, you really don't need to. I mean, Blue Eternal's where it's at. He's pretty cool and has a dagger. This guy just has the cape for regular Eternal and then some hands. But still a good figure, still pretty cool all around. So, guess what I said about cool figure art coming next? That was a lie! That's about it for this one. Until next time, you can check out the podcast. The website, Ramboards, RogerRangersRambles.com, bringing you the latest Toku news in the craziest way possible. And as always, thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. And I assure you, next time will be a pretty awesome figure art. So until then, see you guys next time. Bye.